So a very good morning to all of you, my friends.
Good morning.
Right. First of all, I would like to thank the gurus of this universe and the masters of the universe at the IITD and the IIT faculty of IITD for giving me this lovely opportunity to present my 40 minutes presentation. Dr. Rajan and his team, thank you very much. In gratitude. Right, all of us are friends. All of us are in the field of self-improvement. We are actually change agents. In fact, we can say catalysts of change, engaged in shaping lives of people, guiding them, motivating them, or imparting knowledge, or even applicating knowledge. A lot of functions we do as a trainer. Now, one thing is very sure, that you have something to offer. It's very clear, isn't it so? So I'm asking you, where did this knowledge come from? Is it that you picked up something yesterday from Mr. X, which you want to give it to Mr. C the next day, tomorrow, whatever? Or is it that you have been learning since your childhood? I would say you have been learning this, all these experiences which you are actually picked up from the childhood onwards, from the date you are born, where from the day you have been spanked by your mother for doing some mistakes, when you spill milk, right? When you learn your first ABC letter writing, from there onwards, you have been learning, collecting information and experiences. Now you are ready to give to participants. Don't you see this information, experience, what you have gathered, it has come in a non-linear way, right? All round experiences you have gathered together has brought into a package which you want to share with people. So keeping this idea in mind, I also have chosen a topic which is very much connected to all round learning and experiences. My topic for the day is how to transform into universal love. Now, before that, I would like to make a fair submission that I am not here to teach you anything, nor educate you, nor inform you about anything which you don't know. I am actually sharing what I and you have experienced in our life, and which I am a medium to express. So I request you to give me some unwavering attention so that we can be connected. Two things is required that I'll be getting. One is that, you know, your attention, so that, because the topic can get at times a bit abstract. Second thing is that when you're connected attentively, I will get encouraged. Is that okay with you all? Thumbs up? Yeah, thank you. So how to transform into universal love. When I say universal love, do you feel that, can we bifurcate love into anything, to universal or any other thing? No, love is only love. Love is all enclosing. Love is all around. Love cannot be split. Love has two attributes, right? But still I'm using the word universal for one reason, because friends, all of us, you know that we are all different individuals, born from different background, having our own traits, physical as well as the mental traits, emotional traits of that. Some are small, some are big, some are hefty, some are skinny, some are fat, some are emotional, they express their love in a very gregarious manner, some are very lethargic in expression, some are very quick in grasping the information. Some are quick in grasping information, some are not. So we are actually having our own operating system keeping to all these characteristic traits in us. So we are varied in varied manner. So that is why we are different to each other. But universe is not like that. Universal is all encompassing, which doesn't have a beginning and an ending. It is omniscient, omnipotent, omnipresent. But I would like to ask you one thing. Have you ever thought about exactly what this universe is all about, or what an infinity could be? I'll give a small sort of visuals. You have to do it that way. For example, I am a balloon standing on Earth. If I explode, what is left? I'm not there, the Earth is there. If the Earth explodes, what happens? Earth is not there, other planets are there. If all other planets have exploded, what is balance? Nothing. Now you can understand the universe where it is. It doesn't have any start or end. No beginning, no ending. If you can visualize that mentally, then you'll understand exactly the thing what is universe is all about. Universe hasn't got kshitij or horizon. As human beings, we are used to having horizons. So that is why I'm differentiating universal love and human love. Universal love is unconditional, but human love is conditional. If somebody accepts you fully, you like that person completely. If somebody objects to your something which you feel that not good enough, so you reject that person. So all these conditions are there with us. You have a love at first sight for some people. As far as some people you meet on the street, you abhor, you detest seeing them. So all this, we are made of such operating system which is different to each one of us. Universe as such does not have any operating system of its own. That is why I said this mind-body consciousness is only the factor which makes you different and which operates in a conditional way, whereas universe doesn't operate in a conditional way. That is why I say, why we do not transform into universal love. Now, the question comes back again, why? Why it is not happening naturally to us? That is because of this reason. Are you able to see this, my screen sharing?
Yes.
Yeah. Our problem started here, friends. Whether you believe in karmic theory or not, one thing is very sure, that you have your genealogy, your source of your mother, parents, from whom you came in. They have had their character traits which got into you. Right. So from there, things started changing for you. And you actually been staying in the womb of the mother for 9 months. And when you come out of it, what do? You leave a brick cry. You shout and cry. And what happens there? Your entire system gets activated. You see, when you cry, others are happy about it. Because you're born into this universe and they are happy about it. The thing is this, in the cry, you express that you don't want to be away from your comfort zone from the beginning itself. Okay? So this is one thing which you have to understand. It is not that you're picked up now that you want to be removed from the comfort zone. But from the beginning, when you're born, you don't want to be removed. And why the discomfort happened, you must understand this. Because of light. Friends, light distracts. In a sense, when you come to the light, from the mother's womb, you came to this world full of lights. Light actually has brought in distraction because of various objects. You said, oh my God, how can I deal with so many objects, so much? Then what happens? You are comforted by your doctor, your nurses, and the parents, everybody. You're comforted with and you feel okay. Then you feel, oh, it's not that bad out here, right? So, but then one thing is that you have been influenced, my friend. You have been influenced, subjective influence. Why I say this? Because you have a choice of your own. You made choices there. You want a particular bed or cradle. You want a particular time to be given, for a particular time milk to be given. You want a particular time to be taken out. You like somebody cuddling more than anybody else, any other person. All these variations have happened, you have chosen, you stuck to it. This is what I'm saying, you have been influenced. And this is also, besides those character traits which you have got from your birth, through genealogy, through your parents. Now again, you are getting into such influences. Now what happened here? Here, you have closed yourself by your own choices. You enveloped yourself because of all these selections or choices or whatever you made. You enveloped yourself. Now, you have divided the world of likes, dislikes, right? This ignorance which is staying with you for a while now, you have chosen to choose one thing which you like, you have chosen not to choose something which you don't like. So this is one thing which you have become a prisoner of your own perception. This is what the obstacle for your transformation into the universal law, because you are working in a particular operating system. Now what happens, why we are not transforming naturally? It is this reason. There are methods to transform naturally. Some people can surrender, total surrender. Like you raise your hand and you surrender yourself. But not everybody can do this. In this, what happens? In this, your entire flow of energy from the head to toe flows fully. All meridians work properly. When your meridians work properly, you are full fit. You are entire, your sense organs are energized so well that it's easy to surrender. But it is not possible for everybody. Some have to have different way of approach. Now here, what I want to say is that, you know, since you have limited yourself, you are enveloped with all these likes, dislikes, you have made your world small. You are not able to transcend. So there is another way of transcending, is just dropping the body consciousness. The body consciousness was the actual factor which made you such a different person. But the same thing, you have to drop the body consciousness. How will you do that? You have to go through the body only, no other way. In fact, if you are able to make your body very vibrant with all sense organs working to fullest extent, to optimum level, dropping body consciousness becomes very easy. But it doesn't happen. So what do you do for that? You have to be open. The only one way of dropping body conscious is just try to be open with universe without any restriction, right? So before this, going further about the topic, I would like to take you to a small exercise of 2 minutes, you know, where you have to be with me fully. Can you all close your eyes for a while? Yes. You have not closed your eyes. Please close your eyes properly, because you have not felt the eyelids touching each other. Yeah. Now can you loosen your body completely? Right. Now take your attention to your weight. Do you feel your weight, full body weight? Can you feel that? Now can you feel, where are you sitting? Can you feel the touch of the place, wherever chair, sofa, wherever you are sitting? Can you touch the feel of that? Okay, now feel your body temperature. Right? Now can you feel your clothes on your body? You feel the person within the clothes? Now what is holding you as a person, the complete person as you are physically? What is holding you? Can you search that? Right. You may please open your eyes slowly. Come back to the session. Thank you, friends. Why actually I took all of you for this journey is that you are actually lost this connection because of our own small way of our brain system, whatever you are following, practicing, all that. You are lost connection with yourself as well as connection with the world at large, with the universe at large. So I just want to make you experience this, that feeling your body weight, feeling the where you are sitting. This is the thing which, apart from all the yoga, abhyasa, all that, exercises, all the meditation, thought of abundance, all that. Besides that, if you are able to practice in an everyday manner these small experiences, right? Wherever you are, wherever you are standing, can you feel both the weight, balance of your body? Can you feel how you are holding your hands? All that. These are the things which normally. I would ask you one thing, that when was the last time you touched your hands, left hand to right hand? Do you remember that? In fact, you are doing every day, every moment, but you don't, you are not aware of it. Right? In fact, all of you should understand that all of us are transforming by itself. My question is, how to transform into a universal love? It itself is a misnomer, incorrect. Because you are transforming every moment, each day, each moment. Because the very fact you are transforming, you want to just go out of your shell, that is why you are here. You join IITD for training, to improve your personality, right? You never wanted to be a frog in the well. That's the intention. That's why you came here. In fact, you are transforming. Every time you are transforming. Every moment you are transforming. But you are not aware of it. That's the only thing. You are not connected. You want to. Basically, it's man's nature to go beyond. It's our nature. Because survival is one thing which has touched upon in the beginning. Now it's not survival. Now it's exploring. You want to go further. So that habit, that nature, everybody possesses, but sometimes we tend to forget it. So we need reminders from great people, leaders, all that. So here, now, for example, simple exercises, whatever you do. Like, for example, if you're able to chew properly, that is again a transformation, it will lead to transformation, chewing properly. Have you ever thought that how saliva does good to you? When you start giving importance to understanding or realizing this, then you will know that even eating itself is a big thing by itself. It's a big advantage, big spiritual exercise by itself. All these small factors help us to connect with the universe. That's what we have to practice. Now here, this slide shows about step back, stop doing, look inwards, listen patiently, all that. Basically, you are actually putting all your shackles down. You are standing, you are receiving. You want to receive things. You have to learn to receive, you have to connect people. For this is the exercise which you have to continue every day, apart from the exercises we've been told by people at large, educated, the trainers, all that, in the physical fitness training. But why it's required is this. First of all, physical fitness is very important. Your sense organ has to work at the maximum level, optimum level, to be even spiritually advanced also. For this, your skin plays a great role. Your sense of touch, that is why I was taking you to the meditation exercise of touch. Because skin, at five sense organs, skin is the largest sense organ we possess. But we always are habit of using more of the eyes and the ears. More. We actually forget to give attention to the taste, to touch for that. So once you learn the aspects of skin, for example, skin, as we have in our team doctors, skin has got nerve endings. A good nerve ending is what makes you as a person, as a lively person. So you have to actually work hard to get your nerve endings intact, so that it's always in the receptive mode. Signals, it gets signals. So that signals, if you go to the right place, it activates the right organ. So why here is we open? For example, opening up is very important. Opening up means you're opening the heart, receiving people. The most difficult thing in our life is that you have develop resistance to people. That affects the heart. Secondly, all of us do our job with a lot of haste. Haste also actually blocks the free flow of our blood circulation, because haste brings in the highest rate of pulse rate, which actually creates problem for other organs. They have a lot of mismatch or lack of coordination. This affects our health. This affects the entire process of life itself. Okay, now let's come to the next slide. Acceptance of interdependence. You all understand one thing. You as a person, nobody can claim that I am a self-made man. Because unless people support is there with you, you can't be what you are right now today. We have to understand this interdependence. Independence is not freedom. Interdependence is freedom. Even one has to understand this, because interdependence, you are with people at large. Your energy, your force or strength is much more manifold when you are with people. For example, so yesterday I was watching a song, Dola Re Dola. Dola Re Dola, all that song, no? Tandola, Mandola, all that. So basically, the Aishwarya Rai as well as the Madhuri Dixit, they're dancing. But can you pick these two people and see dance? Most of us do that. Only these two characters, actresses, dancing. But then you don't see the ensemble, the music, the team, the group, the troupe, dance troupe, their performance. Their performance actually adds up to the personality and dance performance of the main dancers. In fact, you cannot just be away with those extra inputs given in the screen. Because what happens is this, that if they are to perform themselves alone, it can become a bit erotic, ugly. But then everybody is involved doing the same thing, the ugliness becomes beautiful. Our life we have to make very beautiful this way, by being connected with people, learning from them, experiencing them, accepting them they as they are. So basically that is what we are supposed to do, because basically you are not alone. Other day I was going to the office for work. I had to catch 10 to train. 10 o'clock, 2 minutes, the train was supposed to come. So I'm rushing through an auto. I caught an auto. I was just coming. I'm getting on, also giving the payment to the auto driver. My pen fell down. Now what happened? So rushed in Mumbai. So a lot of crisscross vehicles moving around. So if I had to bend down, get the pen, it will take a bit of time. But another person, the co-commuter, he picked up pen and gave it to me. It was very, very useful to me, because if he had not done that, I would have missed the 10 to train and I would have reached office late. That means we are not recognizing all this great sort of permutation combination of our life, which is happening every moment in our life. If you start recognizing, you see how life will be beautiful. So interdependence is very pure, very important thing in the transformation of our into spiritual and the universal love. Now, you can also take time out to meet such people, old people, their skin is become very, very soft. Grandmothers, go to them, talk to them, listen to them, give an empathetic listening which you have learned in the IITD lectures. Just listen to them, touch them, feel them. They feel connected. This is very important if you can carry out this such exercises in every day or in, you know, whenever you go to village, meet people, be connected. Thank God you are there. You see, we have missed nature. When last week when I did the same exercise, I felt very good when hugging a tree. Such a great thing by itself. You feel so rock solid, you know, you feel, oh yeah, this is really. Have you hugged? You try today. Go out and hug a tree. You will feel very good. You will feel so, so secure. When I tried this, I felt so good. So this also can develop the touch which you are lost with the universe. You will get back again. Right? Feel the bed. Whenever you go to bed, what you hit? You are so tired, exhausted after doing all digital watching, all that. You know, you go to bed, oh, you hit the sack, sort of, you know, there's a big dialogue, big sort of proverb. Oh, hit the sack. Oh, just fall to bed. No, you don't fall to the bed. You go to the bed, you sleep, you feel the bed. Oh, it's a lovely place. You're going to rest for 6 or 8 hours. How have you forgotten this? When you are a child, your mom used to really pull the strings of the cradle and you used to feel so good. They used to, lullaby was sung to you. You felt so good, you used to put to sleep so easily. Now you're going to the bed without having a touch of yourself. You just fall into it. So why don't we attempt to redo this so that you get touch with the bed and where things you do, where you're resting your entire 6 or 8 hours, you are resting so well so that you are rejuvenated in the morning. Right? This can be meditative, a bath in the shower. Cool. Like you can think it is you are in the Himalayas, where the water, the jharna, that waterfall, is you are standing under the waterfall. You can feel, oh my God, so lovely. Your scalp is so cool. Actually, scalp is supposed to be cool. Always. One medical test for your good health is that, they say in Hindi, sar thanda, pet naram, or pair garam. This is a very fantastic test of your body. And if you are having this, you are going to be in good health, your vibrant self, ready to drop the body consciousness. You understand this very neatly. So once you, every day you take shower or bath, whatever, you pour water on your head, you feel, oh my God, such a lovely thing. You see the privilege of the universe. Like 3 or 4 years before, we never had this tap business, You had to go to the well or the river or the pond to fetch water for doing all these things. Now you are only one term, you are in wisdom, coolest wisdom. Try this out. Have you ever, after your child you handled very well, okay, they have gone, they have become big people now, they are doing, some are multi-millionaires, some are very great executive CEOs, companies or that. But have you ever picked up a child in your hand, small 4 month baby? Oh my God, when I just did it washi, I had gone one visit for a wedding, one woman's child, I just said this, opened, stretched my hand, she gave the child to my hand. I felt so good, my God, so soft, oh my God. I actually, to be very, very truthful, I felt the need to have a second child. Okay, so this is what I actually experienced. So I felt, my God, such a soft person. In fact, when you hold a child, you try this out, please, my friends. When you hold a child, actually you're holding the universe in your hand. Please understand this. It's beautiful. You can connect yourself by participating in adventure sports. Handle fear. Most of us have this problem. In my generation, the problem was this. How to make two ends meet. Right? Roti, kapda, makan. That was a business. So we never thought about all these things, handling of adventure sports. Now the present generation, they have the facility to go into from such extravagant interests or hobbies. And this is the one area where you can handle your fear. What I understand about fear is this, that whenever you fear the most, you do that first. You don't keep it, you don't put it in abeyance or procrastinate or doing that. You just do it immediately. Your fear should go off. And when your fear goes off, you connect. Because basically when you are doing such exercises, when you get into such sports, you are aware fully. And in fact, you are so nervous. I mean, nobody can say that I'm not nervous, I can do things so easily. No, nobody can do that. Right? So you are so nervous. You are, in fact, handling each moment of your existence. And what is that, my friend? It's being in touch with yourself. And if you are experienced and if you succeed in all the activities, you feel so relieved, you feel an achievement, you feel as if you have reached a milestone. This is a fantastic place for you. Now, just burst into a song. I remember my Air Force days, we have lovely campus, as most of us know what military campuses. We have small, big trees and lot of pathways to cycle. Nice to go cycling like this, And nice to cycle. Nice to sing songs like this, like this one. One of this is this. फूलों के ढेर है, आए गनेर है, झूम रही है हवाएं, ऐसी नजारों में खिलती बहारों में प्यार मिले तो रुक जाए, प्यार मिले तो रुक जाए. दिस हेल्प्स, यू फील सो गुड. And then you, after that, you go to reach your home, you park the cycle, and you feel so good, your mom is there, oh, to give you feed or food. So happy. And you hug her, say, oh, mom, was great. Such a connection happens. Such, when you burst up into song, when you're this daily life, daily existence, or hum. In fact, I would say, your life has to be like a flute. When you are able to really sing a good or create a rendition on a flute very beautifully, you are actually connected with the universe in a beautiful way. That is a navdar connection. You know, we have 9 holes in our body, all the holes performing too well. Music happening from all the holes of our body. Don't you think it will be beautiful? That's one thing about the music itself. Now, this is what universal love is, your freedom. You're free. Friends, now here's the thing is, universal love is this, and you don't, by accepting universal love, by surrendering to the universal possibilities, you don't become an ascetic. Right? You are not leaving this world. You are actually connecting, because the 5 sense organs, are you using your 5 sense organs properly? That's my question. We are not. When you're talking to somebody, you are thinking something. When you're eating, you are thinking something. You don't see properly. What they say that, you know, why they say that you are not able to see properly. You are not learned seeing properly. Because when you see, your perception, as I said at the beginning, you are prisoner of your perception. You see that perception in your mind. Can you see in a choiceless manner? That is what they say. Seeing as it is, living as it is. Wherever you go, you are not seeing as it is. You have choices. You have particular way of looking at it. You don't like black people, you don't like white people, you don't like brown people. When, for example, in fact, you only see what you want to see. When I come out of my house, if I'm liking cars, I see only cars. There are many. One beggar is there, one girl is there, right? One person is there, old man is there, carrying luggage on his head. You don't see that. You only see cars because you are so much influence with your personality or thinking. That means you are actually who made your world very small. Secondly, if I like a girl, if I like girls, whenever I come on the street, I say, oh, this girl, oh, fine, good. I get interested. But I don't see the cars there. I don't see any other objects. My entire attention focuses on that. So that is why, that is what we are. So to transcend this limitation of seeing, then you have to learn to see properly, my friends. See here. Properly, fully, full attention, multitasking. What we are talking about nowadays, I know it's a hogwash. It doesn't make any sense. When you are involved fully, then the life happens. Basically, one is surrender. That is, you will connect with the universal consciousness of universal love. Second is leaving the body consciousness. You have to leave your body consciousness. How, I tell you? Have you seen a dewdrop falling from the leaf, right? It's like this. You just can imagine, just close here, you can imagine also, that when the green leaf is there, when the dew is there, it just collects itself, comes to the edge of the leaf. And you can see when it slowly, the leaf bends for it, and the drop falls in a conical manner, it goes down. Okay? So, that's how it appears, as if the leaf has actually helped the drop to fall. That is our job as a trainer. Just guide people such a way that they will feel themselves fulfilled in their chosen life, career. You're just like be a leaf. Just okay, come on, get a slight push, right? So that will help. It should be this way. Or else you see a mango or chart, whatever you see, the nature has the way of doing very differently. and you can learn from nature. Even though, for example, nature doesn't make any sound or noise or anything, you know, it's Mahima. Today itself, you actually had a great Mahima experience, you know why? Did you all know? One thing happened with you, all of you. It is this, that around 5:15, it was dark, suddenly somebody put light, natural light, into the surroundings. Who was that? The sun, right? And it came on top of the head. Now it is what, 12:30, so on the top of the head now. Slowly, did it make any noise, my friends? No, it did silently. When you make too much of noise, it's a big problem. So silently you get across to love. That will also lead to a universal love. Okay, I shall end my session with this song. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.